why is always the statement, which is the core, the basis of our role for this year. And this statement is the district mission. So who knows what is the district mission and who can tell us? It's one sentence. It's the same all around the world. Who wants to...
We build new clubs and support all clubs in achieving excellence.
Perfect answer, Balázs. Thank you very much. This is the core of everybody. Simon Sinek has a really great TED talk about start with the why and about the model. I know that one of the Aero Director's favorite person is Simon Sinek, so that's great to start with the why always, because we need to know what do we represent and why do we need to do that. So this has to be in your head. Every area directors, every division director, and every core team member has to have this in their head when they are making decisions or creating new ways. Then we have a club mission. I don't want anyone to quote because it's a bit longer. We provide the supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. So every club leader has to adopt this club mission and have to make their decisions and their functioning based on that principle. Okay, I want to have a few words about the Toastmaster World 2. So we are in District 1 and 10, but how does it look like? So we have 14 regions all around the world. Nine of those are in the US and the others are around the world. So it's 8 to 6. But the other end of the world is growing really well. So there were forming regions in the last 10 years in China, India. Also, Europe has become a region alone, and Africa has become a region alone. And for those, we need to know a few numbers. You can see we are 358,000. We have these amount of members. What is a really great amount. We are present in 143 countries. That's also really great. And there are more than 16,800 clubs around the world. You also need to know two faces right now. There is Deepak Menon, our president. You usually receive letters from him. He is the president of the organization from India. But we have a president-elect too. And he is Richard Peck. Richard Peck is from the US and he will lead the organization from August 2020. He is the guy at the bottom. Then we need to speak about the region. So where we are. We are region 10. Region 10 and district 110. So it's easy to remember. There are 32 countries, more than 1,000 clubs and 21,300 members in Europe in Toastmasters. So it needs to be learned. There are 8 districts. It's important information for Andrej Brozek, our incoming area director, who won the district speech contest in English, that every district will delegate one person to the regional semifinal, and two of them will qualify to the semifinal level of the World Championship. So you have 25%, Andrej. Good luck on your journey. There are two faces to know also in the region. And we have live here Pat Johnson with us, past international president and Region 10 advisor. And although Tuire is not with us, she is the current international director for Region 10. She's a really nice lady from Finland, from District 1 and 8. And she will finish her term in August and we will have a new international director. There are 3 candidates for the position and we will see who will be the best to win the international director position. As the functioning, the world headquarters is in Denver, Colorado, and international directors are forming a roundtable as a decision-making body of the organization. So every region delegates one international director. And region advisors are the people who are consulting and helping. They are like area directors, but for districts, I would say always, because they consult, they help, and they guide us through lots of things here in our districts. And about District 1 and 10, we are 7 countries. Right now, we are 91 clubs, although it was 100 earlier. But due to the pandemic and other circumstances, our club number is a little bit decreased. Currently, at least yesterday, we had 3,009 members all together in the last 1 year. It doesn't say that we have currently 3,009 members, We had more than 4,200 membership payments, but as the retention is really, really high in our district, it's a bit different. But that's okay. And who we are as a district leadership team. So when we say district leadership team, we are thinking about the core team who is in the picture. So myself, Kalingilea, Balázs, Kuzsel, this is the so-called trio, which we are the decision, kind of the decision makers and representatives of the district 1 and 10. We have the district core team, our administration manager, Lenka Tarapkova, Balázs Gergely, our finance manager, Isabella Takács, our incoming public relations manager, and Lukács Libich, our immediate past district director. But on top of that, we have area directors for A, B, C, D. We have a district parliamentarian, a district webmaster, and all the area directors. This is how we look like. And what do we do? I won't read out loud, but there are various district services what we usually provide from area director level till district director level. And the guy on the picture is Mark Snow. He is from Australia, and he is the only person in the world who completed all the paths in Toastmasters. He was a really great influence on pathways, adaptation of pathways, and he has a nice three-pager which contains all the district services. And we will have maybe a separate session in September about those services, but right now here is the link. You can find it on our district page. It is district at 1110.org. And you can find among the useful information or the file section, you can find that. I don't want to go deeper because we don't have so much time as we started a bit late. Okay, the how do we do our business? This is a mini session about the parliamentary procedures. We have business meetings around the year. Of those, we have two DCMs, which is the district council meeting, where maybe as you were earlier area, you were earlier VP educations or presidents of your clubs, you know that you have to be there, you have to vote on different things, but it is really important how you do that. There is a procedure for that. We call it parliamentary procedures. You really need to practice it to understand. But right now, I would say it's much better to be in person and practice there and have a longer session about parliamentary procedures, because this is more for the kickoff. We don't need to utilize parliamentary procedures here, but we need to speak about it as we agreed to incorporate a session of parliamentary procedures in every DOT. So right now, I just want to share with you the five basic principles of parliamentary procedures. So why do we do that? Because only one subject may claim the attention of the assembly at one time. Each proposition presented for consideration is entitled to full and free debate. Every member has rights equal to every other member. The will of the majority must be carried out and the rights of the minority must be preserved or heard. The personality and desires of each member should be merged into the larger unit of the organization. We have a district parliamentarian called Katalin Pavel. Katalin is in the call. He will host those parliamentary procedures sessions, and we will know more about how in democracies we need to think and how in democracies we need to make decisions in a business meeting. So this is about parliamentary procedures. These are really, really important, and we really need to keep these rules and hear out each other and respect each other. Okay, right now I want to switch to what is ahead of you. We have a different session, but we have a vision. So we defined a vision with Balázs and Kalin in one of our earlier sessions. So this is how we want to look our district in three to five years, and we need to start it together. So we have a well-connected community of clubs in all cities over 100,000 inhabitants among our seven countries in District 1 and 10. So this would be a really big goal, what we want to achieve, but we need you for that. So it's just a vision. If you go to a business trip around Central Europe, you can always meet with a Toastmaster Club and you can rely on people from your community. That would be a really, really great thing to achieve. Then I also want to implement the slogan, which would be hashtag teamwork for this year. You are not alone. We are not alone. Clubs are not alone. We are working in teams. And I have a little story here. So I mentioned that Richard Pack is our incoming president. And I met Richard a few times earlier, and we asked the question before we had an interview with him, and we asked him, okay, we have the four basic core values of Toastmasters, and what would be the fifth one to implement? And Richard had like a half minute shock, and then he said, okay, it's an easy answer. It has to be team. And I asked, okay, but why team? Because alone we are strong, but with teams we can change the world. So Richard Pack is also voted on team. So I have chosen this slogan for the year. So hashtag teamwork will come in lots of emails and all around. So keep your eyes open. What kind of challenges do we have in our year? The restarting the engines and energizing our members. So this is the switching back from online to offline format or hybrid format. We need to think about that, and we need to support our clubs. Reinstating clubs not active during the pandemic. I know at least four or five clubs which halted their functioning for the pandemic period, and they have to be reinstated because they want to continue, but we need to help them. We need to promote pathways even more, because pathways is there, but the penetration of pathways is still not enough, in my opinion. We need to focus on it. We need to create new clubs and sustaining V clubs at the same time. Sustainability is really crucial in every country. And as Clark Dowley, our past international president, told, that it's not only we create new clubs and support all clubs in achieving excellence, but we create new sustainable clubs. And this is the most important thing, to be sustainable. What are our opportunities? I think our combined PR and marketing efforts would give us the edge, and we can grow together. And the community was strengthened by the pandemic. There are lots of inter-club interactions. We can say that lots of clubs are cooperating with each other, and we need to keep it and put it on the offline version, so we have a more active community of Toastmasters, and we feel strong together. Okay, and how can you get information about where you are with all the results? We have a so-called district central, and we have a distinguished district program, which contains a distinguished area program and a distinguished division program. We will talk about that later on, but not today, I think. You can check it out for yourself. As you are now a district officer, it means that you can now get into the Toastmasters webpage, and you can click on Leadership Central and District Central, and you will see the District 110 results, and you can find your clubs, your areas, and you can see how do they performing. I want to ask you to keep an eye on that, because it's crucial for your year to see that which clubs are not paying their dues, which clubs cannot attract new members. So maybe you will know where to help. There's not only one report, but there are multiple reports, like 20, 30 different reports, what kind of achievements they achieved, how much do they need to get the district, a DCP point, for example. So this is the core of your information for every division director and every area director, and also for the trio members. We check it on a weekly or daily basis, which is great. Then you can ask your peers, so area directors or division directors. You can ask your predecessors, so ex-area directors, what did they do? You can read the reports, the area visit reports. And there is always a manual for everything in Toastmasters. This is the most important. You can find the manual which will write about what to do or what not. Okay, and the last but not least, I want to share a few important tasks for the upcoming year. Get trained. You are here. You made the first step. We will have two more trainings, one in September, one in February. Promote our website. I shared the Mark Snow article with you, but you can do it yourself and check it out on Toastmasters110.org. Like our Facebook page, The Wild East of Europe, and be the member of the Facebook group, as lots of information is coming through our Facebook channel, and also empower people to be part of it. Create your teams. Teamwork is dream work. Pat will have a session about that. Never forget to ask for help. Don't burn out alone. There are lots of tasks to do, but the return on investment is really important, and please keep an eye on that. Visit your clubs and fill in your reports at least twice a year. That's for area directors, and division directors have to motivate your area directors to do so. Core team members can learn a lot from those reports, and the clubs can learn a lot from those reports. Check regularly the district central so you know where you are with the statistics. Our clubs are our customers, treat them well. So I worked in sales for 2 years and I learned the lesson that clubs are our customers and we need to serve them as much as we can. Be creative and stay motivated. You learn from every action here. Yeah, this is one of the basis of Toastmasters, I would say. So I want to finish my session. Don't forget about teamwork, #teamwork for the team of the year. Thank you very much.